Hello, everyone. Welcome to our e-commerce class again today. My name is Angeline Wang. Today, we are going to talk about e-commerce marketing strategies. This is the outline of today's class. First, we will talk about Netflix as our case study.To show everyone how online marketing strategies are. The second one, we'll talk about one-to-one market. Then, we'll focus on personalization strategy and loyalty and satisfaction and trust. Of course,we mentioned word of mouth before. Now we'll talk about it again, and we'll talk about it more in the later class. First, I will bring everyone to Netflix case study. What is Netflix? Netflix is the largest.Online movie rental subscription company. It offers a lot of DVDs. For example, more than 90,000 titles, more than 200 categories, more than 55 million DVDs, more than 5,000.Instant viewing movies or TV as episodes on PCs, while Neighborhood Movie Store has less than 3,000 titles. So, Netflix can distribute 1 million DVD a day. Is that amazing? Now, you can see the power of e-commerce.If you run a store online, you can have such a large categories, a lot of varieties. However, if you open or run a store in someone's neighborhood, your capacity is much, much lower. Then, in this slide, we talk about the problems.Netflix faces. Because of the large number of titles available on DVD, customers often had difficulty deciding which DVDs to rent. They don't know. They can't decide which DVD to rent over the large number of titles. You might say, how aboutpicking the most popular DVDs, the bestsellers, something like that. Any problems? Any problems of this simple strategy? Of course. Netflix has to maintain more and more copies of the same title, since people always pick up the same DVD, the most popular one. And...Some unpopular titles were not renting very well. That's not what we want, right? We want every product to be so very well. Yeah. And the second major problem Netflix was facing is competitive nature of rental business.Yeah, this business is very competitive. Netflix competes against Blockbuster and other rental companies, as well as against companies offering downloads of movies and videos. In the next slide, we will talk about Netflix solutions. And Netflix solution 1, they are using Sign Match, which is a recommendation system. And in this system, they have some very, very good tools. The first one is data mining tools. In this tool, they use data mining techniques. They can dig out the film rating and the customers' rental histories and individual likes or dislikes or their preferences with those inputs into the data mining machine. They can output some very, very good recommendation. Because their sign match data mining techniques are so successful, such that both Blockbuster and Walmart.com use this system model as well. In October 2006, 1 million users spend on increase the accuracy of sign match by 10%. Oh, here is 1 million users. Sorry, spend and increase the accuracy of sign match by 10%. So we can see the data mining system's goal is to increase the accuracy. Because the higher accuracy, the better recommendation to the users, and the more satisfactions from users, the more money the company earn. In order to increase the accuracy of this recommendation system, Netflix offer here 50,000 progress prize each year. Goes to the winning team. The team is the team working for Netflix. Every team works on how to increase the accuracy of this recommendation system, and the winner of each year will get 50,000 prize bonus. And this indeed improved the accuracy of sign match over previous year, every year. Then now we take a look at Netflix prize. Oh, sorry. Then, we talk about Netflix solutions too. Friends SM, social network strategy. Yeah, we are very familiar with social network right now, like Facebook. We make friends on Facebook and we view friends status updates. We view the news, the information, the page friends post to us on the wall, right? So Netflix already used this kind of strategy before. The functionalities of Friends SM of Netflix. First, they can invite friends. The second one, they can make movie recommendations to each other. The third one, they can pick at one another's rental list. This sounds exactly what Facebook is doing right now. And I believe everyone must be very familiar with this. Very, very, very similar to Facebook. Basically, it enhances the interactions among members. And then, stir people to rent more DVDs from Netflix. The third one of Netflix solutions is web advertising. Of course, ads is very, very important. For example, they placed a static banner on Yahoo, MSN, LOL, and many other sites. They also use search engine advertisement techniques and permission emails, blogs, social networking, and class fields are SS. And people may wonder, what is permission email? I believe sometimes you go to some website and you register as a member. In the process of registering, it might ask you, do you want to receive any information from us? And probably you will click yes. And then you will start to receive a lot of advertising email from the web. This is called permission because you permit them to do this. And a 5-week activity program with USA Weekend Magazine. This program direct 50 million, wow, is a tremendous number, right? 50 million readers to Netflix to win weekly prizes, costing the company 140 million. Yeah, so we can see Netflix spent 140 million on this 5-week activity, but they get more benefits and income from this activity. So we can see the web advertising, basically Netflix want to gain the reputation from the public in a short time. You must do ads. Now, let's see. According to Netflix, 3 solutions. What's the Netflix results? The results are quite good. The first one, they achieve effective recommendation. The second one, they increase customer satisfaction and loyalty. And let's look at the detail. What is effective recommendation mean? From the statistics, about 70% of the rentals based on SignMatch. So everyone get used to use SignMatch to determine which DVD they want to rent. Okay, and the second one, how to prove the customer satisfaction and loyalty are increased. Because of accurate recommendation, 70% to 80% rentals come from back catalog instead of new recent releases. The back catalog means the old DVDs put on the back, you know, the very old DVD with history, probably like 5 years ago, 10 years ago, but people start to rent them. And increase 90% of customer satisfaction and loyalty, because people can find the movie they are interested in. Did. So they will find this web is fantastic. This web can tell me what kind of DVDs I like. I will not waste money to rent something I don't like. So my satisfaction increase. Therefore, I'm become more loyal to this website. After finishing Netflix case study, let's go back to the e-commerce marketing strategy terminology. Basically, the biggest advantage of e-commerce is one-to-one market. You can imagine when someone buy things on the internet, that's one person sit in front of the computer and the person accept the contents displayed on the screen. So it's one-to-one, display the content to the individual who's sit in front of the computer. So this is the biggest advantage of e-commerce. And how to perform one-to-one marketing? The first one is personalization, which is also customization. The second one, e-loyalty and e-trust. The third one, collaborative filtering, is more like the sign match. It uses others' behavior to predict someone's behavior. The last one is permission advertising and permission marketing. The first one to one-to-one market strategy is personalization. The matching of services, products, and advertising content with individual consumers and their preferences, what they like, and the user profile. Basically, what can we get from the user profile? Some information directly from the user, such as your career, your gender, your age, and your hobbies, and so on. The second one, we can observe what people are doing online. Usually, we use cookie. The cookie is not the cakes, not the desserts we are eating, but some technology installed in the Explorer. It can record your, like where you visit on the web, trace your behaviors. It will record in the cookie. The third one is built from previous purchase patterns. Then perform marketing research and make inferences. It's like collaborating filtering because they want to target at the consumer behaviors. Now, let's take a further step to talk about collaborative filtering. In this figure is a good example for collaborative filtering. Once a customer profile is conducted, a company matches the profile with a database of products, services, or ads. Manually matching is time-consuming and very expensive. Therefore, the matching process is usually done by software engines such as SignMatch, right? The software Netflix is using. And one well-known method is called collaborating filtering. In this slide, you can see a consumer goes to Amazon to buy a book. Heaven is for real. Then we can see in the bottom of the page, the system will provide you some recommendation to buy, such as 20 minutes in hell. It's funny, huh? This recommendation is done by some other consumers' purchasing behaviors. Probably someone who bought Heaven is for Real also bought 20 minutes in hell. This recommendation is done by some other consumers' purchasing behaviors. Yeah, just this, like what we just said. And this is collaborative filtering using others' experiences and data to predict what you might like. The next one, we are going to talk about some personalization strategies. The first one is, you just say what you need to keep in mind if you want to perform some personalization strategies. The first one, what is most important? Customer acquisition or customer retention? It means that you want to find a new customer or you want to hold an old customer. The second one is what types of customers have the highest value? Frequent shoppers or biggest spenders? The third one, how do you want to target customers? Individually or segmented? You want to focus on one customer or you want to focus on a group of customers? The last one is which customer is most important? Long-term buyers or untap new shoppers. So this is kind of similar as the first one. Okay, and in this slide, we remind loyalty, satisfaction, and trust in EC. From Netflix case study, we can know the importance of loyalty. Satisfaction and trust are very important. Netflix use Sign Match and Friends SM social network to make users addicted to their rental site, which increase e-loyalty. Meanwhile, customers get very good recommendation from Sign Match and Friends SM. This increase their satisfaction. Then, every time, Netflix always send DVD to their home on time, increase their trust to Netflix. Finally, here is an interesting statistics from Amazon to support the importance of e-loyalty. From this example, we can see it spent $15 to attract a new customer, while you only spend $2 to $4 to keep an old customer. So people can say loyalty is very important because you spend less to keep an old customer than to find a new customer. Yeah. So this explains the importance of loyalty. Then, as we know, maintaining good customer relationship is also very important in marketing. Because you maintain good customer relationships, meanwhile, you also increase their loyalty, right? Satisfaction, and you spend less money to keep a customer, remember? So, when we manage our customer relationships, we will consider three aspects. The first one is, what values are the most important? Spenders or loyalists? Another is how we segment our customers. Depending on geography, locations, interests, or community. The last one is how to keep customer privacy. This will increase your customers' trust on you. And in the later class, we will spend more time on the detail of customer relationship management, CRM, and tell everyone you can use a very good software to keep a very good relationship between you and your customers. Now, this is the last topic in our class, today's class. And we would like to talk about the word of mouth. It means that you know some products or services from your friends. Some statistics from Zepo.com shows this. Advertising spending, 85% on the internet, 15% on the print. And how new customers acquired heard about Zepos, 44% from internet, 43% from word of mouth, and 13% from other. So please see here, you have 85% from internet and 43% from word of mouth. So you can see word of mouth on the internet. How powerful it is. So as we remind, what is word of mouth? Because sometimes you surf on internet and probably go to a forum, and you see people are discussing about something, and wow, and from inside, you find some websites very good. You can buy a lot of cheap thing and good thing on that website, and that's called word of mouth. It's not ads. Yeah, it's not banner, right? And it's not video. It's just a forum. It's word of mouth. And this graph shows the growing trend of word of mouth from 2000 here to 2008. The grossing sales, the importance increases as time goes on. And this is another graph, a statistic, a research graph from e-commerce marketing in 2011, which is last year. We see here, marketing, around 29% marketing perform on social media like Facebook, YouTube, and around 24% is from search engine. This stands for search engine optimization. I'm not sure if anyone knows why search engine plays a role in marketing, because nowadays a lot of companies pay money to Google and ask Google to put their company in the very top, the first few of the search results. And therefore, if people search for some product and your company is shown on the first few search results, you have much, much, much higher probability that customer will click on your web and buy something. This is called SEO. And 27% is from video. Around 18% is from price reduction and 2% from other. So it is kind of different from our past knowledge, right? Past knowledge will always think, oh, price reduction is the most important because people buy cheap things. But from this graph, you can see the power of social media, the power of search engine, and the power of video. The media, marketing media, become with more variety. And this is our summary of today's class. First, we introduce you guys Netflix case study and show the importance of one-to-one market, the personalization, loyalty, satisfaction, and trust. And finally, we talk about the word of mouth, as well as some statistics about e-commerce marketing. And in the very last, I will give you guys a short video to show how fast the world is changing, and we need to keep an eye to the internet and keep an eye to all the changing strategies we need to learn. Okay, and after finishing this video, our today's class will finish. Enjoy. See you next time.